Hi, I'm Sandy Hirschlein, welcoming you to another Siemens How-2-Drive video, with the goal of helping you better understand and work with Siemens variable frequency drives and related motion control products. In this video, Product Manager Craig Nelson will continue the previous SINAMICS S120 booksize format How-2-Drive series by focusing on the line modules for the multi-axis offering. Craig, the stage is yours.
Thanks, Sandy. One of the advantages of the modular SINAMICS S120 drive system is the flexibility we offer in the various types of line infeed modules, helping to provide the best solution for your application. To review from the previous introductory S120 videos, let's take a look at the three main components of an S120 multi-axis system using the very popular booksize format as seen in this example. We have the control unit, which is really the brains of the S120 drive system and is where all the interfaces, software, and programming takes place. Next is the line module, which is the subject of this video. The main function of the line module is to convert the three-phase AC power into a common DC bus supply, which feeds the motor module inverters. The motor modules then convert the DC into a pulse-width modulated three-phase AC power to control the motors. An additional function that the line module serves is that it also provides an indicator for the motor modules that the DC link is powered up and ready to feed the motor power. For those not familiar with the S120 drive system, the S120 components are typically connected to the flexible backplane called drive click, enabling plug-and-play configuration. Back over to the line module, which is also referred to as an infeed module, let's take a look at the three SINAMICS offerings. First, we have the basic infeed, which is typically the most cost-optimized option. The smart infeed, which is a regenerative line module. And finally, the active infeed, which in addition to being a fully regenerative infeed module, also provides a number of additional features, which we're going to discuss in more detail shortly. But first, before we go deeper into the technical details on these line modules, let's take a quick look at the power flow on some example drive systems. Starting off with the single axis system, we see that in the typical motoring operation, the power flows into the drive and through to the motor. Occasionally, the motor must decelerate or stop and creates regenerative energy back into the drive. This power is fed back into the DC link, and to prevent DC link overvoltage, a braking resistor is used to dissipate that energy in the form of heat. In a multi-axis drive system, which is fed by a single infeed module, we see that in the normal powering mode, the single infeed power is split between the motor modules over the common DC bus. Certain axes, especially in motion control, have load cycles that are going to decelerate, stop, or change direction frequently. In this case, the axes on the right, for example, may be decelerating or changing directions. And that regenerative power is now fed back to the DC link, which in turn lowers our input power supply as that regenerated power is recovered by the other motoring axes. This energy efficient design is very popular with machine designs across various applications, saving significant amounts of energy and costs. Let's also take a look at a machine that has multiple cycles where energy would be regenerating from all axes at the same time. Instead of this power being dissipated across a braking resistor, it makes more sense to recapture this energy back into the power supply. This is where a regenerative line module, such as a smart line module or active line module, really shine. This not only saves money and power bills, but can also create a very green solution for many applications where a good amount of dynamic load cycle is available for energy recovery. Siemens offers three choices in the S120 multi-axis line modules. Looking specifically at the basic line module, we can see this option is typically a diode bridge, usually a 6-pulse bridge called a B6 bridge, but it could be a 12-pulse or 18-pulse in some applications. This is the most basic transformation from the incoming three-phase AC power to the common DC link on an S120 drive system. With the basic line module, power can only flow in one direction through the infeed, which powers the DC link. With the basic line module configuration, if we have a regenerative situation, such as a machine stopping, we would typically use a braking resistor if needed. The conversion on a basic line module with the B6 bridge is calculated as the three-phase AC voltage times 1.35 multiplier factor to come up with your DC link voltage. With a 480-volt three-phase infeed, we'd be powering a 650-volt DC bus, which would have a certain amount of voltage ripple on it from the diode bridge. If we have load hits on the motor or voltage sags on the incoming power, we would see a decrease on the DC link. And vice versa, if we were regenerating power back to the DC link, or we had voltage spikes, we would see an increase on that DC link as well. Now, if we move to the middle selection in our flexible offering, we have the smart line module. The smart line module is regenerative, which means power can flow into and out of the line module, depending on the power differential between the three-phase AC supply and the DC link. So anytime we have an overhauling load that increases the DC link, that power would be recovered back into the incoming line. This technology is controlled by IGBTs, which make this option very dependable and provides fast transitioning between the motoring and regenerating bridges. The DC link voltage and ripple with the smart line module is similar to the basic line module. Focusing next on using an active line module, which offers the highest performance. In addition to being fully regenerative, this option also controls the DC link voltage, so it remains stable and without ripple. If we have any disturbances, whether it be on the incoming power supply or effects from the motor, the disturbances would be buffered out because we're controlling that DC link as a set point value. The DC link is also a buck boost, so the DC link level will be higher with an active line module. Typically, we would be in the 1.3 range for the basic line module and smart line module, but an active module starts out at a 1.4 factor range. Typical default would be a 1.5 factor on the booksize drive system, but could be regulated up to twice the incoming three-phase AC voltage. At a default value of about 1.5, a 460-volt supply, we would have a regulated 700-volt DC bus. This higher voltage allows us to better utilize the motor speed torque curve. Some additional advantages with the active line module include low line harmonics. The active interface module, which is used in combination with the ALM, provides line conditioning to virtually eliminate most harmonics. Additionally, this option allows us to do power factor correction. If we would like to have unity power factor from the drive system, or a leading or lagging power factor, this can all be accomplished with the active line module. Having the capability to regulate the DC link with very little ripple on the DC link makes this the highest performance of the drive system selections. For high performance applications, such as CNC machine tooling, where we want to try to remove any type of disturbances out of the system in order to achieve the smoothest finish and highest tolerance cut, it is typical to use the active line module to achieve this. The active line module would also be a primary choice for applications such as a harbor crane, where there would be considerable amount of regenerating. Applications such as test stands, or even a single axis application such as a centrifuge, would also benefit from having large regeneration cycles that have the requirement to feed back very clean power. The smart line module is also used for many regenerative applications. And this selection would typically be used on converting machines, paper machines, and storage and retrieval equipment, or motion control applications where the active line module's advantages are not required or are cost prohibitive. For the basic line module, more general applications, such as conveyors or machines with predominant motoring load cycles, such as roofing material machines, is where they are best suited. Having this flexibility of the three different types of infeed modules really allows the SINAMICS S120 drive system to be the most flexible and cost-optimized system for the widest range of drives applications. As they are part of the S120 modular design, these different line modules can easily be implemented or changed if the need arises. This modular design also provides a very compact layout of the drive system. An example of this is shown here with the multi-axis book size format featuring the active line module with active interface module and optional line filter for C2 environments. I hope this video helps you better understand the flexibility and some of the key capabilities of the various line and feed modules available for the SINAMICS S120 High Performance Modular Drive System.
Thanks, Craig. If you'd like more information on the SINAMICS S120 drive system, a good place to start is usa.siemens.com/SINAMICS-S120. Thank you for watching, and please drive carefully.